right.
You wanted to specifically work on bunker play. We're going to do the circle drill that I just mentioned. I'd like you to try it. I think that you, playing with you the other day, I noticed that you had a little bit of trouble out of the bunker. So I'd like to help you out with that. I don't want you to be discouraged when you go in the bunker. So we're going to work on the circle drill. So I'd like you to first see if we can zoom in just to see the circle, just so we can show it and see what it looks like. This is going to represent the amount of sand that he's going to want to take out of that shot. And first off, like I said, the triangle with the arms, you're doing that just fine. And the soling of the club, for the purpose of this, you can touch the sand. That's okay. No, you're not going to. So first off, I'm going to open your stance up a little bit, point it that way. I'm going to get that club face to be pointed this way. Okay? So now I've got your club face pointed at the flag. Your body's pointed like this, which is good. That's where you want to be. You want to point it out there because that means you're more open and it gives you more room to swing, and that's the whole idea. So let's see you hit a couple of shots out of that circle. Just so that way I can break up a couple more spots for you. Or we can just do that too. That's fine. Alright. Let's keep his shots. And if you guys notice, he's hitting these shots pretty well. Another really good shot. Now your body, your club face, I did it up. The line, and I'm going to draw these lines for the purpose of you seeing it. So I want your club face to be pointed that way. I want your body to be pointed that way. So just think of it like this. This line right here, okay? And if I was to put the golf ball there, this circle, you would be pointed. Your ball would go that way, right? So just you can leave it there. You don't have to draw the circle this time, but you can do it again later.
A quick question before you hit. Is the club face itself going this way or is it going that way?
The club face itself is going that way.
Okay, so it's going that straight line.
Okay. You know what? Yeah, it's going to go that way, and that's where the club face itself should be pointed throughout.
Okay. So the idea is to finish high.
You want to finish high?
As opposed to crossing across my body, like to trap the golf ball, the idea is to finish as high as possible, leading towards the target, although I'm aiming so far out left.
Yeah, and the reason you're aimed that far left is because I wanted to open you up a little bit towards the flag, or away from the flag, because it's going to open up the space.
Okay.
And the space is so important, especially when you're dealing with short game. This is very important. I mean, you always want to be, your body, if you're a right-handed player, you always want to leave it a little open so you can have some space. Until we get to putting, and that's a different story. But let's see you hit a couple more. Remember taking it up a little bit steeper. I'd like to see you open up the face.
Now, do I want the ball in the center of my
stance? You want it in the center of your stance. Yep, center of your stance, opening it up just a tad bit. There you go. And then you're going to take it steep, and you're going to come through it. Not decelerate. You're going to accelerate through the shot.
I think I got a little bit.
That was a little thin, but that's... golf balls, I think you're doing great. That was much better.
Right the flag.
Very good. Didn't have that much swing. Do you want to hit it higher? Okay. Let's set back up again. Open yourself up even more. And open that face up even more. That's gonna get the loft of the club and bring it out towards me. Bring the club face towards me. Like that.
There you go.
That was really good.
It was
on a down slope. If you hit, now the difference between a golf ball checking out of the sand and releasing is going to depend, on the receptiveness of the green or how much golf ball you hit or how much sand you hit. obviously if you hit more sand, it's gonna release.
Right.
If you clip the ball and you hear that sound that Jonah was talking about earlier, that's gonna, like the sound, just like that, you're gonna catch it with on the grooves, and that ball's gonna be rotating and it's gonna check up. That's when you get the spin. With a lot of practice, you can work on it.
That's a really good one to end on.
So good. Did you feel like you got a lot out of that? I mean, we can work on that all together.
I mean, all but one was on the green. That was before, so.
All right.